Hey there, viewers! Are you looking for veggies to add to your dinner? For many people, this is done with their very own garden. But gardening is not as easy as it looks. I mean, it's not rocket science, but it does require you to learn about growing plants. If you're a beginner, you'll love our video. Today, we'll be talking about 11 veggies to grow in your home garden. How do you grow broccoli and peas? Is it possible for beginners to grow Brussels sprouts and beans? We're talking about all this and more. Number 1. Broccoli. Love adding broccoli to your pasta and noodles? How about broccoli soup? We've heard great things about the nutrition this wonderful veggie offers. It's loaded with antioxidants and vitamin C. Eat it steamed or raw to get the best of its nutrients. But how do you grow it? Broccoli is usually suited for growing during spring and fall seasons. It's a cool weather plant, but still needs ample sunlight for about 6 to 8 hours a day. You can either plant them in spring so the harvesting can be done in the summer, or you can plant them in late summer for a fall harvest. It's best to grow only one broccoli plant in a pot, and make sure the pots are between 12 and 16 inches deep. If frost is an issue, you can always bring the plants inside and put them back out again after the temperatures get warmer. You'll need to keep a lookout for cabbage worms, as they like to feast on these heads. Covering the plants with a bedsheet that's light in weight could help prevent damage. How do you like to eat broccoli? On its own? Raw? Steamed? Share your preferences with the bestie community in the comments below. Number 2. Peas. Peas taste really good, whether you eat them on your own or add them to other dishes like mashed potatoes. They taste awesome when you cook them with rice. Pea, rice, and yogurt is a mouthwatering lunch that lifts my mood. If you're a pea lover, it's time you plant one in your backyard. Growing peas takes minimal effort. If you're new to gardening, then peas are the best place to start. You'll need a pot that's about 10 inches deep and a cage around it for the plant to climb. Peas are also a cold weather plant, and when the summer comes, they'll stop producing. So in case you have a limited amount of space in your garden, you can replace your pea plants with something suitable for the summer weather. Number 3. Green beans. Beans are versatile and nutritious. You can pair them as a side dish with a lot of main course meals. They're heart healthy and offer you loads of fiber and protein. Green beans won't be able to survive frost, and seeds will end up rotting. On the other hand, green beans also stop producing around midsummer. But if you keep watering the plants, they will start producing as soon as the temperatures begin to drop. You'll need to harvest them on the regular. If you leave the beans on the plant for too long, they'll mature and become stringy. Number 4. Brussels sprouts. Most people have a love-hate relationship with Brussels sprouts. Whether you love them or not, you cannot deny their good nutritional value. You can grow Brussels sprouts in your home garden as long as you give it enough sunlight. Brussels sprouts also take a total of 130 days to harvest. You'll need to time your planting of the seeds in early summer so that they can be ready for harvest when the first cold winds show up. By giving them a bit of exposure to frost, you can improve their flavor. Number 5. Tomatoes. Love tomato soups and sauces? Well, you need your own backyard full of flourishing, juicy tomatoes. What drives most people's interest towards gardening is the prospect of growing their own tomatoes. I mean, it is a bit of a hassle. Knowing the things to look for in tomato plants is a drag. The important thing is tomatoes only grow in warmer temperatures. The best way to start is by planting the seedlings in the pot and keeping them indoors before moving them outside. This can usually be done during May. Tomatoes are susceptible to blight, so you'll need to watch out for those signs. Number 6. Bell peppers. Bell peppers take a longer time to be ready for harvest. You'll also need good planning, as they can only be planted after the last frost is done for the season. You can put the bell peppers indoors in potted plants before eventually moving them outside. Once the plant is in the ground, it's less of a hassle. Aphids and flea beetles tend to attack bell pepper plants, so you need to watch out for them. The best way to handle these pests is with an insecticide soap. Before we move ahead, here's another video you might like. Veggies are great, but sometimes they can give you gas. Watch this video to learn which foods can make your fart smell deadly. Number 7. Beets. Beets are a favorite in my household. You can add them to your soups or eat them alone. Beetroot salad with cucumber and carrot tastes awesome. It makes an excellent addition to noodles and pasta as well. As if this wasn't enough, you can use beetroot in several DIY skincare products. It makes for an excellent lip and cheek tint. Get that rosy glow. Beets come with a 2-for-1 advantage. You can eat beetroots as well as the leafy green part. The best time to harvest beets is when the roots have grown to 1 or 2 inches. At this size, they're tender and sweet. If you let them grow larger, the roots tend to lose their flavor. If you're planting them in a pot, then it has to be at least 12 inches deep. Once they start sprouting, you'll need to thin out the seedlings to just 1 per cluster. Number 8, leaf amaranth. Lettuce and spinach tend to spoil when they're exposed to heat in the middle of the summer, but that's not the case with leaf amaranth. You can grow this plant through summer without worrying about losing them to heat. The leaves of this plant have a tangy flavor and can be used in a number of dishes. It's very nutritious and packed with vitamins A and C, calcium and iron, among others. They're also easy to grow as you can scatter the seeds in your garden. You can pluck the leaves after they've grown 4 inches. Number 9, carrots. You might be surprised to learn you can even grow carrots in your back garden. It can, in fact, be simple, although you might need some time figuring out the best period to harvest. You'll need loose soil and cool weather to plant carrots. They also take a lot of water. If you add mulch on the soil after you plant the carrots, you can seal in the moisture. If the top of the carrots are visible, then it's usually time to harvest. You can use that method or wait around 60 days after planting to harvest your carrots. Number 10, kale. Kale has become a popular part of healthy diets, has a great nutritional value. This plant grows in cool weather and is in the same family as broccoli. You can plant the seeds in a pot and keep it indoors before transferring to the soil in your home garden. Or if you prefer, you can plant these seeds directly in the soil. Kale won't die under frost. Actually, the flavor of the leaves improves. You must, however, keep it out of the summer heat, as the leaves become bitter if they're exposed. They're also easy to harvest, as you can cut the leaves you need and leave the plant to regrow. Number 11, pumpkin. Want to know which is the easiest veggie to grow? One that can sprout almost anywhere. Why not grow pumpkins in your backyard during Halloween? All you need to do is bury the pumpkin seeds in soil and the shoot will sprout in a few days. Pumpkin soup, here I come. So now you know how to grow your own veggies, but that isn't enough if you want to get the best of their nutrients. There are veggies you should be eating and ones you need to avoid, like the plague. Next comes in cooking. You could be cooking veggies wrong, killing all the nutrition they carry. Learn more about 8 healthy vegetables you should be eating and 8 you shouldn't. You can also try 12 ways you're cooking your vegetables wrong. Go ahead, click one. Better yet, watch both and learn more about how to eat healthy veggies. Do you like gardening? Let us know in the comments below.